Catholic Church. I've heard it said in the Baptist Church. I've heard amen said. I've heard the word hallelujah. I've heard the word hallelujah said amongst my Muslim brothers and sisters and said amongst my Christian brothers and sisters. Well, the word hallelujah. There's a church out today that has a song that says hallelujah is the highest praise. But we're here today to celebrate this rite of passage from childhood to a level of adulthood. He don't need no credit card yet. But he does need more of what he demonstrated today. More responsibility to be a part of his community. Because you see, your name is Mordecai, Ariel, Ben Levin, Ben Yisrael. I have to say this to you. Mordecai is one that stood firm in the face of adversity and would not bow down.
Yeah.
Haman tried to get him to bow down to the God that he served, that he wanted to make of himself. Then you have the name Ariel, meaning a lion of God.
Yeah.
Then you have the name Ben Levi, meaning between. The word Ben just doesn't mean son. It also means between. It means between that which is joined at the hip.
Come on.
And then you have to turn around with that name, Yisrael. The name God gives you when you succeed in the struggle. You always have to remember that you're going to face adversity in life. But never let any adversity you face conquer you. You stand. If you fall down, you get back up.
No man's need. Judaism is not a religion. especially his 12 sons, were not dwelling together in unity. As a matter of fact, Genesis 37 verse 4 says that Joseph's 10 older brothers, Reuben, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Issachar, Zebulun, Dan, Naphtali, Gad, and Asher, hated him. Did all 10 of the older brothers really hate him? No, but they were jealous that their father Jacob had chosen their younger brother, the big mouth, little know-it-all, dreamer, to be the next patriarch. In the beginning of this Parshah, Joseph is walking around like a big shot, showing off his coat of many colors, and telling his family all about the halom, or dream, that he had the night before. The next time, in Genesis 37, verse 7, he pretty much tells his older brothers, I have a dream that I'm going to be bigger and better than all of you, and all of you are going to bow down to me, like I'm your king. Two lines later, in Genesis 37, verse 9, he tells his whole family, including his father and mother, that in the future, they are all going to ishtachaveh, or prostrate. Yes. Lay down flat in your faces and worship me. Even though the Lord blessed Joseph with the ability to have accurate vision of the future while he was asleep, and his father Jacob had taught him how to properly interpret his dreams, that doesn't mean that Joseph can walk around telling his family, are going to worship the ground I walk upon. It doesn't take long for his 10 older brothers to get fed up and Joseph foolish arrogance. One day, after Joseph had gone too far, he also was too far from home for his dad, Jacob, to protect him. According to the Pentateuch, the Blue Book, on page 143, the note for Genesis 37, verse 20, refers to another book of use in Judaism called the Midrash, and it states that Simeon was the first of the brethren who planned to get rid of their brothers. Yosef Baal HaHalomot, Joseph the dreamer. Simeon, who was a little hot-headed and quick to shed blood, suggested murdering Joseph and then tossing his body into a pit. But Reuben, who was the eldest of the brothers, said, no, just push him into the pit. Let's not get his blood on our hands. Reuben was trying to buy Joseph some time for Simeon to call off. The Torah says in Genesis 37, verse 22, that Reuben planned on coming back later and helping him escape from the pit, and was going to allow Joseph to run home to die. Once they tossed him to the pit, Reuben went for a walk, probably so he could figure out a plan to help Joseph escape from Simeon's wrath. While he was gone, Judah got the bright idea to sell Joseph into slavery. The Torah says in Genesis 37, verse 27, that Judah recommended selling Joseph to his uncle Ishmael's people, the Ishmaelites, before they could get rid of Joseph and make a buck. At the same time, a group of Midianites came along and spoiled their plan. The Midianites sold Joseph to the Ishmaelites for about 100 bucks. A lot more stuff happened in this portion, but I'm pretty hungry. Yourself. If you were a part of Jacob's family and you were one of the children of Israel, what part would you have played in this week's Torah portion? Would you be Jacob, the protective father, who doesn't discipline his favorite child? Would you be Joseph, who has all the answers and doesn't respect anyone else's opinion? Would you be Simeon, who wants to murder his brother in cold blood because he said the wrong thing at the wrong time? Would you be Reuben, who's supposed to be the leader, but instead is the follower? Would you be Judah, who's trying to sell his brother out for a couple of dollars? Or would you be one of the brethren that were too scared to stand up against injustice and just stood there and watched what was going down and didn't say anything to their father when they got home and just went along with the lies that their older brothers told the head of their household? Where did you stand in this story, brothers and sisters? Shabbat Shalom.
Has any promise. Only if you honor your father and your mother Then you are promised that your days will be long upon the land which the Lord your God giveth thee. So never forget, you are the son of the commandments, but you are still the son of Maricar and Micah.
Amen.
Know that, understand that, love that, and appreciate that.
Amen.